Hi fellow YouTubers, it's yours truly here, Mariana of Darkroom Glamour, bringing you a contest entry. Yes, I haven't done one in like a very, very, very long time. And I came across this contest as being thrown by ex-Catherine's Bomb X. Hey girl, thank you for making a great contest, especially Moulin Rouge theme. Hello, one of my all-time favorite movies. Love, love, love that movie. And this is one of two entries that I'm going to enter for your contest. This is the first one. It's inspired by how Christina Aguilera's makeup was in the music video Lady Marmalade and my own take on it. I've also added these, you know, Diamonds Are Girls' Best Friend, these pendants that were given to me by a friend of mine from YouTube. Hey Angie, you know who you are. And I hope you enjoy this tutorial. And good luck to all the entries of the contest. This is a lot of fun, and I'm glad to be a part of it. Enjoy the tutorial. Bye. First, I'm going to start off with an eye base, which I'm using NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk. All over the eyelid, like so. Not much is needed because it's very creamy and very blendable, so you're just going to need very little just for that area of the lid. And then you're going to grab a very satin, very white, pearlesque eyeshadow. And I'm using NYX and Geisha. And you're going to apply that all over the lid. So you can set the NYX Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil. You're applying this all over, from front to the end. Use, what I did is I combined Cherry from NYX with the red pigment that I have, and that's why I created all of this like over exaggerated blush around the eye look. You see I also got it on my hands, but regardless, you gotta take your brush, swizzle around the little palette with the cherry and that red pigment, loose powder I mean, and tap it off some excess, and then you gotta go right above the crease. Right where that line is where the white ends right there. And go this way. Around there. And then bring it around the eye area. Like so. And then like if you're going like doing like a U, you're going U like this, back and forth. And bringing it down. So you can get that redness around the cheek area. I know it looks exaggerated now, but when you blend it out with your brush, if you have a brush like this, flat like this, even better. And just in circular motion, work it, and then work it up here in your eye, like so. See how this work coming out, like so. And then you're gonna go with your black eyeliner. Liquid eyeliner, I'm using my Revlon Colorstay, and you're going to apply a very medium-sized to thick line across your eyelid, but starting from here, because you want it to be kind of cat-eye-ish, so you're going to carefully apply it there, without getting it in your eye, then drag it across. So thick like so, don't worry if it's a mess, because you're going to be using a black eyeshadow to smoke it out, like on that side. Especially at the end, fill it in, especially in that corner. Like so. And then I'm using Jane in Clubbing. That's for the smoky eye and then to get a more depth to the eye. So, a very thin crease brush. Like so. Grab some on your brush. And then in the outer corner here, just bring it like this up to the crease. Don't worry if it's all over the place because you're going to like smoke it out. And then bring it also to the bottom. If you need to reapply after you started like blending it out, go ahead, but it's not always necessary. Okay, just add a little bit more of the red to make it even more impactful and dramatic. So I'm just blending it more just around the eye I did previously. And blending it very well so it doesn't look so harsh and not blended. So yeah, let me just finish that blending. We'll be right back. I got from Claire's, I stuck two at the end, one in the inner corner of my eye, which I will add at the very end. Let's just move on to quickly the brow area. I already filled in this eye previously. So I'm using my Benefit Browsings and Medium Brown to fill in the eyebrows to make them darker and more dramatic. So quickly start the wax tinted and then form them. But extend it a little bit to the end, like straight down as Satine did in the movie. Just add it for a more dramatic effect, like so. Exaggerate. And then the powdered part to fill it in much more. For the lips, I'll be using a couple of things, if I can find them again. This is from Fantasy Makers. I got this on Halloween. It's used for anything. I use it for my lips, any black pencil eyeliner, and any high gloss lip gloss you can put over it. So starting with this, your black eyeliner, you're gonna outline, you're lining line your lips, like so, going thick at the very ends. Don't worry if you're a mess, because once you like blend your lips, it'll be fine. And grab some of this and just pass it on your lips like a lipstick. It's like a blood red. How pretty. Now let me just add the little jewels and other things I need to add. Spectacular! And I'll be right back.
Spectacular! The words of the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be dumb with wonderment. Returns are fixed at 10%. You must agree that's excellent.
And on top of your feet, you'll be in all the history.
So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years. So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting.